Good afternoon, dear students. Today we are going to start our fourth chapter of English, The Little Black Boy. This is a wonderful poem written by William Blake in 1789. And this is a poem has taken from the Song of Innocence. The William Blake is a famous poet, and he has written so many songs. So this is a song poem, and this is a poem he has written when the time when slavery is legal, and still slavery is there that time. And through this poem, what message he want to give us? Let's see. I will not break the suspense. Let's see. My mother bore me in southern wild, and I am black, but oh, my soul is white. The writer is the poet is telling, expressing his views through this poem. He is saying that my mother has given me birth in southern wild. He is pointing out the his birthplace, that his mother has given him birth in South Africa, and he is telling that I am black. And he is telling I am black, and but my soul is white. He is telling that although I am black, but my soul, my inner heart is still white, and it is white as an angel is the English child. And he is telling my heart, my soul is white as an angel. Angel color, you have seen, like that I am, my heart is white, like that English child. But I am black as if be rived of light. And he is telling that yes, I am black, like something bereaved means something that is not good, means that is bad things, whatever bad things are there. Meaning of bereaved, to be deprived of something, means something that is bad, that is not good. He is telling I am black like that thing, bad things. I am black like bad things. So here poet is telling, expressing his views, that this through this he is trying to express that see, this type of racialism is there that time. And usually if we will look at the history, we will see so much difference is there between black and white people. So much criticism is there. People don't want to live with a black child, black people. They don't want to sit, like here in India, casteism is there. Like that black and white racism is there in foreign countries, mostly in American countries. So here the writer is express his views through this poem. Let's see what happens the next. My mother taught me underneath a tree, and sitting down before the heat of day, she took me on her lap and kissed me and pointed to the east, began to say. He poet is telling that his mother has taught him under the tree, and we are sitting together. We sit down before the heat of day, means before the afternoon time we are sitting, and my mother want to tell me something, and she took me on her lap. And he is sitting in the lap of his mother. Lap means in leg of his mother. And she kissed him, and she pointed towards the east, and say, she is pointing towards the east and saying, what she is saying? Look on the sun, rising sun, there God does live and give his light and gives his heat away, and flower and trees and beast and man receive comfort in morning, joy in the noonday. And the writer is telling that his mother is telling to him, ki look child, from east sun is rising, and God here, God is living. And from here, God is giving us light and heat.
and that heat and light that is that all person are getting. Flowers, trees, beast means animals, men, everybody is receiving heat and light from the sun. And that God is giving to everybody. He is not differentiating ki I will give light only to black people, I will give light only to white people. No, He is not differentiating. He is equal for everybody. God has created us and He is giving all the thing, natural thing He is giving to everybody, not to individually. And He is giving comfort in morning. And when He is giving comfort in the morning, means when we are sitting in the morning, we are feeling very good. And we are happy in the noonday time. We are enjoying in the noontime, noonday. And we are put on earth a little space that we learn to bear the beam of love. And this black bodies and this sunburned face is but a cloud and like a shady grove. And he's telling that we are living in a little we are living in the earth and a little space here, a little space here. The poet want to express his views that that time black people, those who are suffering from racism, they are not getting so much freedom. They are giving us a little space to live, and they have to adjust so many things. They have to compromise so many things. They are not getting so much freedom. So here he want to indicate that, and that's why we learn to bear the beam of love. And here the writer is saying that that's why God has given us power to bear all this pain, suffering, and beam of light beam of love. So God is loving to them so much. And this black bodies and their sunburned face, and she's telling, and whatever bodies, whatever our black bodies are there and sunburned faces are there, is but a cloud like a shady grove. And she is telling that to his child, that whatever we are having, that black body, black our face is sunburnt, no, this all thing God has given, like that it is a cloud that is having a like a shady grove, means it is just like a cloud that is upon us. And so for when our soul have learned the heat to bear, the cloud will vanish. We shall hear his voice saying, come out from the groove, my love and care, and round my golden tent like lambs rejoice. And he she is telling to his child, so when our soul, when our body, our soul is able to bear this pain, suffering, we will learn to bear the heat of that heat. Bear to heat means pain, suffering, whatever they are struggling, whatever struggle they are going through, that when they are able to bear, then this cloud will vanish. With this cloud, whatever cloud of pain, suffering is there, that will vanish away, that will took away. And that time we will able to hear his voice. His voice means God voice. God's voice they will able to hear, and saying, come out from the groove. And then he will tell to us to come out from the all problem, and my love and care. And he will call us from that all the thing, whatever problem, whatever suffering they are having, he will call us from that, and we will go near him. And and round my golden tenant like lamb rejoice. And when then we will go to his place, we will go towards the gods, and we will enjoy like lamb is enjoying, like that we will rejoice. So these things writer mother is saying to the child. Then after that, what happened?
did my mother say and kiss me, and then I say to little English boy, when I from black and he from white cloud free, and round the tenant of God like lamps we rejoice. And after saying all this thing, his mother kissed him, and he then the writer sorry the poet go to the English boy. English boy is there. I will share with you one animated song of this lesson that you will watch and enjoy. Okay, so he went to the English boy and he told to him, hey, listen, when you will free from when I will free from this black cloud and you will be free from the white cloud, then we will go near the God and we will play like lamb and we will enjoy, and I will shade him from the heat till he can bear, and to lean in joy upon my father knee, and then I stand and stroke his silver hair and be like him, and he will be then love me. And what the writer is poet is saying in this poem, that when this heat, when this all the problem suffering, whatever things are there, when I'm able to bear, then I will go to my father's knee, then I will go to God, and there we will enjoy, and we will with our father. That time I will stand near him, and then I will stroke his silver ear. And he is telling that that time you are also there, I was also there in heavens. So there I will play with your silver hair. He is telling to the English boy that that time I will play with that silver hair, and when I will play with the that, I will be like with you, like you are. I will also become like you, and then you will love me. Now he is not liking him, I think. So through this poem, poet is giving a wonderful message that racism is not good, and this is small things is there in the minds of the child. Nowadays we are not seeing racism. Nowadays we are seeing rich poor, that category realization is there, class level is there, class level differences is there. If any poor boy is there, we are just thinking, oh, he is poor, we will not play with him, we will not give him things, how can we will go to his home, how if he will give anything to eat to us, how we will eat that things from him. That type of class difference we are doing, that is not good. So I think the poet is suffering from this racism so much. He got so much criticism in his childhood. That's experience he has written through this poem. So students, I hope you will like this lesson. And so from this lesson, what message you got? Please comment me, message me in the group, and I want to know. Every time I will not tell you what you will learn from the story, what you will learn from the poem. You will tell me what you have learned from this lesson, and comment me. Everybody comment, I want not only 2-3. So students, I hope you liked the chapter, and tomorrow I will give you notes of this lesson, exercise and notes tomorrow I will give you. Today you will write a word meaning of this lesson and read the poem, and note down this poem in your copy, and I will give you summary also of the poem, our explanation, summary explanation of the poem, that notes also I will give you, and question answer and everything, rest things tomorrow I will give you. So have a nice day. Goodbye.